are you?
Oh, good, good.
Good morning.
Not too fast, but... The wind's gonna help.
Yeah, everybody notices the wind's blowing all this away from you, so... It's helping you a lot.
We'll go one at a time. The other person will just be a backup. Okay? You'll notice it starts to cake on top of it a little bit.
Come on around this way. Get out. Walk on up here a little bit closer.
There you go.
Now you see the importance of the wind.
See, if the wind wins,
if the shifts on it.
You can fight it that way, but it's a lot easier to go up. You have one more.
But you've got about 15 seconds to do it, so that means you have to get in closer to the fire. And in order to get away from the heat, you got to come in lower. So come in low, get in close to the fire, and sweep from left to right, pushing the fire across the pit away from it.
Okay, Bill? That sounds good after all.
Sweep it like you're sweeping back and forth. Sweeping it back and forth across the whole entire pit. Back and forth, back and forth. There you go.
Okay, he did it. We were getting to wonder though.
It was a battle there.
Go ahead, Jared, I'm down the car. Come on. Okay, thanks. That's just to do it.
Okay.
Good. Try to get as soon as what we got. Okay, go ahead and let's prepare to back out. Go ahead, half gate the nozzle. Back on out there. Go ahead and set the pedal down.
Ooh.
back and forth now. Pushes all that to the back side. It's difficult. Okay, do you hold your position here?
Over there, Dr. Stevie.
Yeah.
Al.
Yes, that's it.
Okay.
Depending on what they say, see if we want to use it or not. We had to change the galley cup holder. This is a prototype. It's not exactly like it.
It doesn't work as easy as this one. It's going to take a little manipulation, because if you just try like this drinking in 1G, this will seal off here eventually.
Yeah.
Or you can take this package and hold it down and consume it down to the last milliliter with it.
See, the other thing I noticed right away is this does not retain the straw as well as the other containers do.
It should have the same sentiment.
No, this is really weak.
Is it?
Yeah. You want to try this one?
There was one of them
that there's no septum in there.
No septum.
Yeah.
Two packages.
That's what
check
the
quality on it. It's not in there.
Yeah, you're right.
That would be a real problem.
When you get to the end of the, this is like emptying a gas can without a breather tube.
You're an Iowa farm boy. You should have milked cows before. You know how this works. Yeah, like the beverage containers. The very first one we're going to try is the beef goulash. Do one of you want to try opening this?
These silver packages are commercial products.
Just retort packages?
Retorts, yeah.
Whose are they, by the way? Just out of curiosity.
A company called Pruitt Brothers.
Do they package under their own name, or do they package under other?
Yeah, supplies? Just under their name, and they just sell to institutions right now. They're not selling commercially. Retail market.
I'm taking some of this stuff from different suppliers up the backpack, and it's remarkably good, except it's heavy.
We like these, but they're lower in calories and lower in sodium than the military packages.
For the next one. Have we cloned this one yet? This particular option?
I'm going to have to eat it all, do it.
We might nine-course meal. Don't make a mistake and OD on the first one. Beef stroganoff with noodles. Mm. Use your scissors. Get into those. Whenever y'all are in space, do you usually open it up as far as that, like you just did that one?
Yeah.
Go ahead and open it all in.
Except for sausage patties, because it'll escape on me.
This is big. Okay. If y'all need another plate, here's some extra ones. Those get too messy.
Tortillas nowadays?
Yeah. There's one right there.
And I vote that we pick the whole wheat.
Do you like the whole wheat?
Yeah,
I've never tried them before.
That's just a little more flavor than the...
Typically Indian flat bread is whole wheat.
Mm-hmm. I think that's why I like it.
Yeah. I got tremendous interest from the Japanese people when I went to aerospace meeting. And they mentioned two names. One, I don't know how we're going to do it, about sushi. But anyway, that... They liked the theme of having an international food. And I got the support from ESA, European Space Agency. The French, you know, guys, they said that it's a very good idea and they're going to support mm-hmm. and going to participate in our program. And so you think it's a good idea that?
I think so.
Okay.
I don't know if y'all heard me, that last one, the beef chips with mushrooms, that was another Truett Brothers farm.
It's a what?
Truett, it's from Truett Brothers.
Oh.
Verified.
Okay, verified.
Charlie?
Yes.
The step before Vox was fanned, is that correct?
Was fanned on.
It's on.
Okay. Check both purge valves.
I just need to see around, because I told you. Yeah.
A little bit over to your push. There you go. Alrighty.
Again, purge valve going closed.
Purge valve 2 to closed and locked.
Closed, helmet verified.
Okay. And ready for the check. How's your cooling?
I'm running a little cold right now.
Likewise.
Everybody's got...
Edgar, EV2 is a little cold.
How's EV1? I've got full hot dialed in, but it's not doing much. You hear the suit creaking and groaning and popping.
I should have put the valves.
Yeah, I'm reading 4.3, 4.4, 4.2. That's good. Just leave it there. I'll let it sit for a while.
Okay.
Still pressurized, Kathy. Need somebody to pressurize her.
It's going to be close. We'll make it.
Hey, trust us.
And we have a semi-rigid tether here, so before we call it quits, we want to look at that.
And Charlie, I think the main thing there is, this is just a suspicion, and at this point we haven't really looked at it in the water tank, but again, with those, I would bet you ought to take me out of the airlock position, Bruce, position me, hook them onto a handrail somewhere after we're both in, because they're fairly massive things that probably not worth risking the airlock walls, beating them around.
Okay, both good?
You're good, leak check.
Okay, let's go to the EMU curve. O2 actuators. Depress.
Four. Back and press.
Okay.
Go down. All the way around the SCU here.
Okay, and periodically just flex your arms and legs and stuff and make sure we don't, you know, you get cooling adequately. Okay, we're on the pre-breeze clock, 50 minutes. Goodbye. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I'll be back. Let's get a good book.
Right.
Son of Bag stays in. That stays in.
I wouldn't have described Charlie that way myself, but I can do it.
I was going to say, I could be taking you out of here, Bruce.
If you want, we can bring in the tether.
Yeah, I'd like to see, we can imagine ourselves inverted and we'll look at it again tomorrow, but Charlie might want to take a look at that. Ellie, how did we want to do this? I'm going to read, you're going to read, I'm going to do, or I'm going to read and you're going to verify?
That was what we're, I was going to ask you guys. You want me to read them to you and one of you do it?
For the airlock stuff, yeah. For the other stuff, I guess you're ready, we both do it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Alrighty. And we'll have to simulate this since you're not anywhere. Airlock depress valve to 5.
Okay. Depress valve is 5, mark.
Press ought to be coming up. When we get to 6, we'll get a, well, we got a little alert tone there. When we get to 6, we'll get a...
airlock pressure of 6.
Yes. Gauge pressure and water pressure.
15.0 and 15.0.
Okay. You need to?
15 and 15.
Okay. And check your gauge for suit press.
4.4.
4.2.
Already. Okay, Kathy, airlock depress valve to 0.
Okay, going to 0 on my mark. Mark, beep.
And again, we check to make sure that the gauge pressure on the suit does not exceed 5.5. Okay, Bruce, you can start configuring the waste tethers for egress. We'll simulate that.
Okay.
My right,
upstairs,
your
left.
I am. EVA.
I'm not
here yet.
No.
Keep going.
You start all the way across.
Press. Yeah, with the pad. Yes.
One more.
Okay.
There we go.
And the airlock DPEDT is about 0.
Roger, I'm opening the outer hatch.
All right.
Crank.